Hello everyone, this is Mainak from Civil Center and welcome all back to our channel and another video on Tekla Sticks with Anil. So friends, we are going to discuss about the releases of secondary beams in today's video and the concept behind it. So what happens is when we have a beam which don't have a column to column connection on both sides or column connection on one side, and like this particular beam, as you can see here, this particular beam is a secondary beam. It doesn't have any column to column connection on both sides. So what we do the releases of go double click on this particular beam and do this releases. As you can see, we go to the releases as pinned. And when we have a connection in which one side we have a column and another side we don't have a column, like this one. So in that case, we do one particular end as, you know, as you can see here, one particular end as fixed and one particular end as pinned. So what is the concept behind end one and end two? How to determine the end one and end two? We will discuss this in today's video so that you can easily, you know, fix the releases or, you know, just adjust the releases of the secondary beams in the Tekla Structural Designer software. So let's get started. So first of all, I'm going to give you a very brief, you know, example in a very simple way so that you can understand. Suppose we have a particular column here and this particular column has a particular beam. So this is a beam, as you can see here, and this beam is joining to another beam here like this. So you can name this beam for our comfortably. Suppose the name of the beam is your B1 and the name of this particular beam is B2. So B1 is connecting to B2 and this particular beam, let's say it's connecting to other beams like this. It's a continuous one. It's going like this. And it is also going like this. So suppose let it be B3 and let it be B4. So these are the beams which are connecting, and this is a column, and you can name it as like C or C1. So this is a column and these are the beams. So how can you determine which is the end one and which is the end two? So we'll just determine that the N1 and N2. So for that, we need to know about our coordinate system. So for knowing our coordinate system, it is a basic coordinate system which we follow here. Suppose I'm just drawing axis here, and you can give the normal axis symbols just to represent it here. So this is it. And suppose this is our y-axis and this is our x-axis. So this particular axis, as you can see, x and y, and if we just also draw the origin also, the origin will be at, as you can see, it will be at 0, 0. So this will be our origin. So if we go from left to right, then it will be positive, and if we go from bottom to top, then it will be positive. So this is the concept behind everything of determining n1 and n2. Suppose in the beam b1, left is this one, right is this one. If you're seeing from the top view, you have to remember that if you're seeing from the top view, then your left is, if you go from left to right, then it is positive. So left one is our end one. You can see this is end one and this is our end two. So end one here, if you can see here in the beam B1, end one is your fixed, because it has a column to column connection, and N2 is your pinned. Now moving on to the column B2. So in the B2, this is the vertical member. If you're seeing from the top view, this is vertical. So we're going from bottom to top. So this is our N1, bottom one, and the top one is our N2. So the concept is as simple as that. And in B2, as you can see, both ends, we are not having any columns. So for the B2, the end one, as you can see here, the end one will be your pinned, and also the end two will also be pinned. Similarly, let's put a particular column in the B3 part or the B4 part. So for the B4, suppose the two columns are like this. And what will be the N1 and N2? Here, this one will be our N1 and this one will be our and 2. So for the B4, what will happen is both N1 and N2 will be fixed. So for B4, N1 is fixed and N2 will also be fixed. So this is the concept behind fixing or pinning a particular beam in the Tekla structural designer. This is a doubt which many students and many professionals who are taking training from me, they ask it. So I thought that I could clear it out for all so that everyone can take the advantage of this particular thing. So if you like this video, you can share it with your friends, and also for more lectures and more videos on Tekla structural design, you can subscribe to our channel. And if you are watching for the first time, make sure to subscribe. And also we are launching a 5-day workshop on how to make a structural drawing starting this weekend, that is the 24th of July 2021 to 28th of July 2021, in which we'll show you how to use the results of the Tekla structural designer to make a structural drawing. The cost of the workshop is $499, and the timing will be from 7 to 8 Indian Standard Time. So if you want to attend that workshop, make sure you can do so using the link which has been given in the comment section. It will be pinned in the comment link of the particular workshop. So thanks for watching.